championships and pride on the line, the DA Stars hit the track for what could be their final time this season in the top 32. The Holford Motors team looked to have had the perfect start to the weekend when Luke Fink qualified second and earned himself a solo run. And then teammate and rookie sensation Lee Pidwell had a shock win over Lyndon Reynolds. The team were on a high until they realised they had to go against one another in the next round. Top qualifier Christian Pickering was also joined in the solo runs by third qualifier Tom Monkhouse and a very fortunate Leighton Fine. After putting the car into the wall in practice, Team CTS remarkably put the 180SX back together and allowed Fine to post a qualifying run. He managed to end up in sixth position and, as fate would have it, was granted a solo run after Alex Sciaccia was forced to withdraw. Beau Yates kept his title hopes alive with a solid win over Chris De Jager. Fernando Wirl looked to be having a return to form in a close-fought win over James Martel, while Paul Austin and Jack Monkhouse's wins were made easy. In between rounds, the SureFlow exhaust team whacked a turbo in their LS1-powered 300ZX. Unfortunately for them, they drew a red-hot Robbie Bulger in the first round, and it was the reigning champ who won the battle of the V8s. Matt Mingay then opened up his big V8 to pull away from Clint Brown in their battle in what was the beginning of the end for the Milux Civil team. Danny Vahumas' big straighten coming out of turn one handed Adam May the victory, and Adam Borneo Trawella was stunned by the speed of Eugene Aronson and went down in a rerun. Eugene's teammate Trent White wasn't quite so fortunate. Both in R32 Skylines and both running Federal tyres, Trent was looking good against Nathan Weisel. But a slight mistake on the second battle was enough to hand Weisel the win. Kuda El-Houli was one of the real favourites coming into this round and was looking forward to battling fellow Victorian Luke Jacobs. The Digger R32 was forced to withdraw with mechanical problems, however, and the People's Champion smoked his way into the top 16. The top 32 was finished off in style, with Travis Dunstan rolling out the Zumba.com 350Z for its first tandem battle. The car is still in its early stages of development, but even with limited time behind the wheel, Travis was able to throw the car around and force Darren Appleton into a rerun. The Afro eventually got the win, but the Zumba team got some valuable track time in a car which is a mouth-watering prospect. So all the contenders got through the first round unscathed. Beau Yates will meet Paul Austin in the top 16, and Leighton Fine will have to go up against his old teammate Darren Appleton to keep his championship hopes alive.